And what's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. It is your friend Cheap Lutz. How are you doing this evening? It is Monday evening. Normally, I roll out the teases a little bit, more planned out, but obviously I can't do that today based on how the teases were rolled out to us. So, you know, it's all good. I had a hat on, so now I look like Count Olaf right now for some reason. Shout out to anybody who knows what I'm talking about. It would be a more obscure reference if the Netflix television show didn't come out a few years ago, but you know, it's all good. Neil Patrick Harris, he kind of slayed that role. That was pretty good. Not a huge fan of the books. I was when I was a little kid, but he kind of held it down. Anyways, we got new glitch packs tomorrow. Hooray! Obviously, first things first, we got glitched Gary Payton. His glitch is obviously shooting, being that he just took a fat three right there. We also got Talen Horton-Tucker, PJ Tucker, and Montrezl Harrell. So let's take a look at the actual cards that we're getting. So first things first, it won't pause at the right point. This is where my technological discrepancies come into play. So obviously we got 96 overall Gary Payton, who should be cracked, honestly. I don't really think there's any issue with Gary Payton. Like, he might have a slow jump shot. I think he's probably gonna have the same jumper as Jeremy Lin, which is actually pretty decent this year. That's typically who he shares a jump shot with. I could be totally wrong about that. It's usually either Jason Kidd or Jeremy Lin. So either way, Gary Payton is going to be the most cracked point guard in the entire game, especially because he can shoot. I mean, people are running Caruso and DeJounte Murray in their God squads at the moment. So you can only imagine how cracked out Gary Payton is going to be. Going to be an absolute nightmare, and he's going to be one of the most, if not the most expensive card in the game. I still think like Hakeem probably going to be more. DeMar is probably going to be more, but I think he'll be in the top five of expensive cards for sure. Then we also got Drazen Petrovic. Now that's a really interesting one. The reason I say it's an interesting one is because if he has an athleticism Evo, he's probably not going to be the greatest card in the world. I mean, yeah, if he can dunk, I mean, he'll be okay. If he plays like semi-competent defense, he'll be all right. But if he has a defensive glitch, Drazen is going to be cracked. Like, if he has cracked out defensive tendencies with badges, Drazen could legitimately be a top tier shooting guard in this game for a select part of the player base. And then we got Robert Williams. I really don't know what they're going to do with him. If he has a 3-point shooting glitch, I mean, he could be really good as a power forward. Like, because at that point, I mean, he's essentially just going to be Ben Wallace that can shoot, right? Like, obviously with the worst jump shot, and there's going to be some differences, but for the general consensus, I mean, that's what he's going to be. Then honestly, I feel like I really wish I could get excited for these like glitched Evo cards, but the Evos are so ridiculous, I don't even care. Like, Talen Horton-Tucker might be decent. PJ Tucker, he can play small forward. Like, he'll actually be pretty decent. Still a little bit too small to run the small forward. Like, he'd be better as a two guard. If he can play two guard, great. Montrezl Harrell, I don't know. I feel like they said it here. Okay, so we got 3-point shooting Montrezl Harrell, 3-point shooting Talen Horton-Tucker, and athleticism PJ Tucker, but PJ can usually shoot. So it's going to be interesting for sure. All right, hold on. So yeah, we got 3-point shooting glitch Montrezl Harrell, 3-point shooting Talen Horton-Tucker, and athleticism PJ Tucker. I mean, yeah, PJ Tucker can usually shoot. If you're wondering why there was a cut there, check it out for the second straight video in a row. I almost was murdered by a Triscuit. I really should stop eating Triscuits for my own health, but like, it's the woven wheats, man. They're so delicious and salty, which sounds kind of gross now that I say it out loud, but it's just my, don't even want to start talking about how my throat can't handle it because it's going to come off weird. But you know what I'm saying? Triscuits, they will take you out 100%, but delicious in the process. If I go out eating a Triscuit, I'll go out dying how I love to live, eating Triscuits. Either way, I have a Mario up here. PJ Tucker is who I was looking at. PJ has got an actually good jump shot, and it's like on quick too. 6'5 with a 6'9 wingspan. He comes standard with an 80 three-pointer already, and he already comes standard with like corner specialists and stuff. So I expect him to play competent defense, have a good 3-point shot, but then he's also going to be able to rim run relatively well as well. So he's got Steph. Yeah, he's got Steph's crossover. Like, they're going to juice up his stats a little bit. I mean, he'll be pretty good. Talen Horton-Tucker, he has his own release, which no one else has. I'm curious to know exactly what that is. I don't know. It's usually kind of similar to like Marion's release. I would assume that's going to be the case. You know, 6'4", 7'1", wingspan. He's going to be able to shoot. I don't know. What exactly is he going to do? I guess is my question. Like, what is he bringing to your team? Like, is he going to bring, you know, like a vaunted amount of like rim running or defense with him? I don't know. I just don't know much about Talen Horton Tucker, I guess, man. You know what I mean? Whatever. And we don't actually have a Montrezl Harrell, but I do want to look up Jeremy Lin. And in addition to Jeremy Lin, I want to look up Jason Kidd, because I feel like these two cards are going to be very similar to what we're dealing with. So he's actually got his own release, and Jeremy Lin has Jaden Springer's release, which this would actually make sense because Sean Livingston also has this release as well. So this could actually make a lot of sense for Gary Payton. And look, I know what you're thinking, like, Richard Hamilton sucks. I agree. His jump shot is weird, though, because like with Sean Livingston, I feel like it's really good. But for some reason with Richard Hamilton, I just cannot consistently green it. But with Sean Livingston, I was greening it consistently. So I don't know if there's a change in the upper that maybe that's the issue. I don't know. If he has this release, though, I mean, it's not going to matter at the end of the day. Like, really, because you're getting the best defensive point guard, which if he doesn't have Hoff glove, come on, man. Like, the badge is named after him. At the same time, 2K loves to do this stuff. Like, they'll quite literally roll out a Rodman without Hoff Worm. Like, you know what I mean? They used to do that all the time. So it wouldn't shock me to see him only have Gold Glove, which is just disrespectful. But he's going to have elite defensive tendencies. No question. I mean, he'll be pretty much maxed out on ball steal and pass intercept. He'll probably be decent on contest and block, too. Probably just contest. Block will probably be bad. But either way, he's going to be a top-tier point guard. I mean, there's no way around it. Like, he's going to be a monster. So let's go take a look at the market and see what's up. All right, let's take a look at the market here. I mean, realistically, first and foremost, like, John Wall is the number one person this is going to affect. John Wall is still, I don't want to say he's going to be better on Courage End, where rim running is a little bit more overpowered, but I feel like he'll be a little more versatile on current gen, like, for sure, because John Wall can still shoot as well. The fact of the matter is, Gary Payton is going to be better defensively, obviously, but John Wall is going to be a little more varied offensively, so I feel like it's kind of a wash, and I feel like most people that would use John Wall or have John Wall are probably still going to use him off the bench, so it doesn't really matter. So I actually don't think his price really comes down all that much. I mean, we're at the point now where I just feel like none of this stuff really affects the market. Like, Harden's kind of a specialist player, so I feel like if people are using Harden, like, they're probably not going to sell Harden. I feel like, you know, Curry is not going to come down in price. I mean, Curry's still 400K. It's been 400K since the day he came out. I'm pretty sure this one's still, well, this one's more affordable now, but still. Dwayne Wade, we could see him drop. There's only two Dwayne Wades up. Like, I just don't think anybody really cares at all at this point. Like, we didn't see Embiid drop in price after we got Hakeem. You know what I mean? Like, he went from being like 500K to like 350, 400. We're not at the point where any of these guys are going to drop. When these guys are going to start dropping is when we start getting opals or consistently cracked cards. Once we start getting consistently cracked cards, that'll kick these guys off of people's top squads in the game. Or even when we start to get guys who are a little bit more affordable that are just a cracked, that's kind of when we're going to actually see some drops. But I don't know. I get super bored talking about the market this year, which sucks because it was like my favorite thing to talk about last year. But it's just like, I feel like nothing happens, like, at all. I feel like every single time I go to talk about the market, it's just like there's no change. Like, yeah, a top tier card will be down like 64.7K. But I don't know, man. It doesn't have the same splash, dude. You know, when you see a card that was going for 300K and all of a sudden it's going for like 120, you know, then you want to talk about it. You want to jump up and scream off the rooftops. But I just feel like it doesn't have that same oomph. You know what I mean? A lot of that probably has to do with the fact that, I mean, nothing's really come down in price anymore this year. Like, nothing. I just feel like even cards that came out week one are still the exact same price for the most part. Like, the only card that's really significantly gone down in value is realistically Wilt. Like, Wilt has gone down, and I mean Pink Diamond or above, by the way, I would like to specify. Like, Wilt is the only one. Like, Tatum's still 300K. You know, MJ is still expensive. There's only one MJ up. I just feel like nobody's gone down. Maybe Dame might have. I mean, he's still like 200K though at the end of the day. Hell yeah, Katana, I feel you. So it's just like, I don't know, man. Super boring. I don't think Gary Payton really affects anyone's price. I think we could see Drazen Petrovic affect some prices, but it just depends what he's like and what his glitch is, because I don't know what it's going to be. And that'll really kind of hold it down. Robert Williams, by the way, will probably affect the price of, like, I don't know. I don't even think he affects the price of Jared Allen, honestly, at this point. Like, I don't know who he affects the price of. It depends what his glitch is, too. If it's shooting, I mean, he'll be good, but his jump shot is not good whatsoever. So, I don't know. I guess we'll see tomorrow. You know I'll be up early opening way too many packs. As always, been your boy, Cheap Loots. Peace.